weekend to you. Welcome to Leading Edge. Good to have you along. I'm Jerry Anderson. Well, it didn't take long, did it? Days after new congressional districts, mostly favoring Republicans, were approved by the legislature and signed by the governor, we have competition, folks, in Toledo's 9th Congressional District, where Marcy Kaptur has represented voters since first winning election in 1982. Yes, I said 1982. Of course, the new 9th has a pro-Republican flavor by voter makeup, a little edge there to the GOP, something Ms. Kaptur really has never encountered. So with that, I want to welcome in one of the Republican candidates, the only current office holder to announce her candidacy to be the Republican challenger to Ms. Kaptur, Theresa Gavarone. You know her. She's been on our show before, an Ohio State Senator, previously an Ohio House member before that. Yes, served on Bowling Green's City Council, 4th Ward, if I may say so myself as a resident. Good to see you, Theresa. Last time I checked, Bowling Green isn't even in the congressional district you wish to serve, although by law, you know you don't have to live in the district. So help me out on that one. Sort that out for me.
Absolutely. Well, actually, I'm a resident of Huron, Ohio, in Erie County now, and registered to vote in Erie County.
You're talking to me from Huron, Ohio right now?
Yes, I mean beautiful Huron, Ohio.
My heart hurt. I'm a Bowling Green. We can't lose population in Bowling Green. All right. So you did that for the expressed reason of being a candidate in this race.
Well, we had been looking, yeah, you know, at places on the lake. I've always loved it out here. And then when I had the opportunity of representing this area in the 2nd Senate District, my love grew even deeper. And so we just decided to get a place up here in Huron.
Your Senate district, you tell me, comprises what, fully a third of the entire larger congressional district?
Yeah, about a third. About a third of this congressional district I currently represent in the Ohio Senate.
When did you decide? I'm doing it. When did you decide?
Well, honestly, if you're talking to people in your district and talking to people in this area, you know, how they think things are going, people are really upset. Oh. They're upset at the skyrocketing gas prices, the energy prices. They're upset at inflation, the government mandates and out of control government spending. And they want to change. So okay.
I know you want to clarify this because you did change residences into a district that was being redrawn under a process that you were co-chairing in Columbus, to which some would say, sort that out for me.
Absolutely. I was not involved with drawing the maps in any way, shape, or form. Did not draw the maps, did not sponsor the legislation that the maps passed through.
Okay. We had Rob McConnell, the senator, whose bill containing the maps became law.
Right.
So you didn't draw the map that was ultimately approved and did become law. In fact, you didn't really see it until the day it was approved because it was drawn on a Monday night and voted on Tuesday.
Right.
And yet you were co-chair of the process. And you could see where it appears transparency was kind of tossed to the curb here.
I don't think transparency was tossed to the curb at all. We listened to hours and hours and hours of testimony in the committee. And that testimony was taken into consideration when the new maps came out. I mean, we had a tight deadline because of the delay in census numbers and everything else.
The census was late getting in.
We needed to get this done by November 30th, but we wanted to make sure that we had enough, you know, opportunities that anyone who wanted to speak on this legislation had an opportunity to speak and address their concerns.
Let's get back to your race here, because race is on. She's announced, folks. Marcy Kaptur has served, you know this, in the U.S. House of Representatives longer than any woman in U.S. history. You were first appointed, not elected to the Ohio House in 2016, but then won the seat at the ballot box. Same at the Senate, appointed, but then won the seat before voters. Why would 9th District voters turn their back on 4 decades of Washington experience? Or is that 4 decades precisely why they should, in your opinion?
Well, as you mentioned, I started out in Bowling Green City Council and moved up. But if you look at my time in the state legislature, I've gotten a lot done. I've got a track record for listening to my constituents, finding solutions and getting legislation across the finish line. I've lived in Northern Ohio my entire adult life. I went to college at BGSU and law school at University of Toledo. My son goes to BGSU. I mean, we own a business in Bowling Green. And, you know, we are deeply entrenched in the area, and I've represented this part of Ohio for years. So it's important that you have a candidate who knows the area, has a track record for getting out to her district, listening to her constituents, and getting things done. I talk to a lot of people in my district who are frustrated that that Marcy Kaptur really hasn't gotten things done for them.
All right. A couple more things on the congressional front, but you are still a state senator, my state senator. So I'm going to ask you some Columbus stuff too, but I got to take a break. Hang in there, okay? She's in Huron, Ohio, which, hey, Huron folks, it's a great town. It's all fine. I'm going to take a break. This is Leading Edge. We're back right after this.